Today we will be as well. As you know, students, India has a very long history of the caste system. In fact, this caste system was devised specially to segregate the masses and different communities based on an ancient system. In fact, a complete hierarchy of how communities were to be divided, how they were to be placed in the social hierarchy. Now, this was done primarily to serve many purposes. And as you can see this pyramid here, the people who were at the receiving end of everything were the ones at the lowest level, that is the untouchables. They were seen as untouchables. On top, of course, the gods favored the Brahmins, then the warriors and kings, that's the Kshatriya community. Then you have the Vaishya, then you have the Shudra, and then you had the untouchables. Untouchables were people who, as we know by different castes and communities in our country, they're broadly known as Dalit. So this is an account by a Tamil Dalit feminist and novelist, and her name is Faustina Mary Fatima Rani, and she is known as Bama. Now, Bama recalls her early childhood, and she wrote her first novel, Karakku, which was published in 1992. And this novel focuses on caste and gender discrimination. I will be discussing this chapter in two parts. Setup of caste, and the other one talks about a similar situation in America, where another writer, another female writer, how things have changed and have they really changed is something that we need to think about. And as we read this chapter, we will see how the changes have taken place. Now, this particular chapter, Bama looks back at her childhood. And she remembers her childhood, how it was. And she was in class 3, a little girl. And there she was one day walking back home from school. And she always had the tendency to stop in the marketplace and appreciate the activities of the marketplace. Lot of colorful things being sold and people looking here and there. And the village marketplace was, of course, full of many, many activities, where you had people selling sweets, and then there were nice, lovely festooned things which looked very attractive. So all these things where somebody was selling fruit, somebody was selling vegetables, and things like that. It was very active scene. And so her walk home from school, this little girl, when she would walk home from school, she would normally take about half an hour to reach, because she would stop and admire all these things in the way. She would look at all these things, and for her it was her pastime. And she remembers how time used to pass, and then she used to go home and she used to resume her studies. So here we see that she is also, you know, going one day to school, and she sees that the threshing floor had been set up. Now, what is a threshing floor? A threshing floor is a particular place where they thresh the wheat and separate the chaff from it. And there were two bullock carts which were supposed to be driving the particular thresher, and that's how the wheat was being separated. Now, when somebody, some high caste person was sitting, or a rather reputed gentleman was sitting, he seemed to be of very well disposition, and then Bama saw her elder from her street. Now, where she used to live, an elderly gentleman came. He was very well respected over there, and he came from the bazaar. And what was he carrying with him? He was carrying a bag of vadais, now bhaji, banana bhaji or vadas or something like that, he was carrying that. But the way he was carrying it was very odd, because he was holding the bag with a stick. It was balanced at the end of a stick and in a very odd manner. So Bama found it very funny, and then he gave this bag to that zamindar or to that man, and then he took it from him and began to eat the vadai. Now Bama was very angry and hurt, because she went home and told her brother that today this is what she saw. And so her brother was not amused. He did not laugh. He shared with her their condition. And what does he tell her? He tells her that we people are untouchable people, and that we are considered to be from a low caste, and so we are not allowed to touch anything that the people from the higher castes are eating. And so that made Bama feel very angry. She felt very hurt about it. And her brother also shared the fact that because they were untouchables, there was no way they could ever get out of it except through education. So what does he tell her? That education is one way that we will be able to get out of this cycle of caste and other things. Yes, today also we see people being discriminated on the basis of caste and community, and that in itself is a curse. And imagine the people who have to face it. It is very unfortunate, and it should not be done like this. But at the same time, we have to understand one thing, that to throw away these indignities and gain respect, education and progress are very important. So these words had a deep impression on Bama. And Bama began to study very hard after that, and she stood first in her class. And after that, Bama had many children as her friend. Many students reached out to her and became her friends. So we see how this particular chapter tells us that racial discrimination, unhealthy treatment towards humanity in general is incorrect. And we should not support or encourage anything like that. Over centuries, this caste system has suppressed communities for centuries. And that is something that needs to change now. Even though the government of India has implemented the Mandal Commission, it has made a lot of changes in society. And as you can see, this particular status in life that people have been accorded according to their caste. Now, caste is something which nobody can help or change, and that is the most unfortunate aspect of it, that people should not discriminate and people should look at communities as they are and accept people for their individual talent. But that is not happening in our country even today, and the writer wants to bring this forward. So if we are faced with such a situation ever, let us remember not to discriminate on the basis of caste or community, but to only go on the basis of ability and capability. That is more important. There may be many people who are very capable, but unfortunately they do not get a chance to progress in life. But if that is moved away, then you will see that there is so much also. So this is part one of this chapter. I will be doing the part two in the next class. Thank you. This is the end of your class.